Good morning, everybody. I'm very happy to be here with you. It's a great occasion, opportunity to be in contact with all the audiovisual worlds in Korea. As you may know, Shoot the Book has been created collectively by the French publishers in 2014. And since well, we have developed with the support of a French institute, Institut Français, different various manifestation of this event throughout the world. And we started with Los Angeles, then Shanghai, Bombay. Korea should be the fourth country where we developed Shoot the Book. And we are really happy to have this opportunity because I think that there is a real complicity between both audiovisual world, French and Korean. And what we are going to see today is to have a full pictures of the audiovisual market in Korea, which seems very important for us in order to provide the right items in order to allow you to know the French publishers and the French literature. And our members, publishers, have a lot to learn from you. Because they know they cannot present any books. They have to know what will be interesting for you to adapt. I want to be brief because what you are going to say is much more interesting than what I say. And therefore, I'm going to put the floor over Marianne Cossera from the Institut Français.
Thank you, Nathalie. I'm also very happy to be here with you, of course. It's a great opportunity to learn a lot about Korean audiovisual market, and thank you for all the speakers who accepted to speak with us today. I'm rather delighted to hear for the first time that we could develop more connection with the Korean audiovisual market, which is like the first step today. Institut Français is working all over the world to open up new opportunities for French IPs to be able to show their potential for screen adaptations. I think that, like said Nathalie, Korean market and French market has a lot in common. Quality at first, like really willing to offer great stories with editing. And we are here for the first step to understand better how we can size the proposals we can make from French books. And this is so the first step of coming events, hopefully, which we'll be able to meet live. I want to say that we will try to go to Korea, but also that we have an event each year in Cannes, and we will be happy to use these two occasions to be able to continue the discussions between professionals. I will stop here because, as I say, Nathalie, I think we have so much to learn from you that we are all ears. I will give the floor to Jean-Romain Mico, our audiovisual attaché that most of you know, our French editors are going to know a lot about him already, but we are so happy, and thanks to him, all the Korean team of the Institut Français, or maybe I should say all the French team of the Korean Institut Français, or the Institut Français in Korea, to put it like, to phrase it perfectly in English, for their great work. They are really opening up so many opportunities for books, fanbooks in Korea, that we are so grateful here for the work they are doing there. So thank you, Institut Français. Thank you to all of the speakers that are, who are going to enlighten up right now. And hello to all the French publishers, which I'm so happy to meet again on this occasion. Jean-Romain, the floor is yours.
Bonjour. Merci pour vos mots introductifs, Nathalie et Marianne. Je ne peux qu'être d'accord avec vous. Merci au CELF et à l'Institut français pour leur soutien. Merci à tous pour votre participation. La Corée connaît un essor incroyable dans les industries culturelles et créatives via la Hallyu, la vague culturelle coréenne, qui déferle à travers le monde grâce à la K-pop et au succès des films comme Parasite, des K-dramas comme Squid Games dernièrement. Tout ceci vous sera présenté aujourd'hui. Merci aux intervenants d'avoir accepté de participer à cette conférence. J'espère que leurs présentations vous seront d'une grande utilité pour attaquer le marché coréen. N'hésitez pas à participer au grand salon en Corée, à savoir le Salon du Livre en juin, le BICOF, Busan International Comic Festival, fin août, début septembre. Sur la partie audiovisuelle, le BIF, le Busan International Film Festival, l'équivalent du Cannes en Asie, le BCM, Busan Content Market pour la télévision. Bien sûr, le service culturel sera là pour vous accueillir lorsque vous viendrez en Corée. Petit rappel technique, vous avez un onglet « Questions » pour poser vos questions par écrit. Nous prendrons les questions à deux moments. Lors de la présentation de l'étude de cas de l'adaptation du livre de Guillaume Musso, seras-tu là ? Et après la table ronde, en fin de conférence. N'hésitez pas à poser toutes vos questions tout au long de la conférence. Nous ferons le maximum pour y répondre. Si malheureusement ce n'était pas le cas aujourd'hui, nous prendrons le temps évidemment de vous apporter les réponses ultérieurement. La conférence se passe en français, en anglais et en interprétation du coréen. Merci pour votre indulgence. Nous allons essayer de respecter le timing annoncé dans le programme que vous avez reçu. Kim Na-hui, Adélaïde, critique de cinéma et journaliste, sera la modératrice de la conférence. En plus de ses talents d'analyse, elle est trilingue, ce qui facilitera grandement nos conversations durant toute la conférence. Merci à tous encore une fois pour votre participation et très bonne conférence.
Bonjour à tous. Hello everyone. I'm going to share my my presentation first of all. Just to let me I'm going to talk about all these K Korean contents today in 2021. Okay, let me start with this great news. It just arrived a few days ago. Koreans currently consume the platforms and how OTT services. A few days ago, CJENM alone to acquire over 80% of stakehold in Endeavor content is La La Land production in Hollywood. It was with $775 million. So which means that CJENM, they are very ambitious to be global and international level studio. Several platforms subscribed for each person in South Korea. So every Korean just watch it at least 4 hours a day, mainly via their mobiles. So YouTube is the number one successful platform in South Korea. It's another example. In 2019, $220 million for Netflix subscription. It increased to $480 million in 2020. So 65% of its number of monthly subscribers in 2020, and it's not all. Besides Netflix, Apple TV Plus, Disney Plus, there are several domestic Korean platforms such as Wave, Watcha TV, LG U Plus, etc. In January 2021, the number of subscribers of Netflix Korea hit almost 9 million people. Wave is the second platform in South Korea subscribers, over 3.8 million subscribers, and TV is third with 2.8 million. So overall, 1 out of 5 paid for watching OTT service, and including family accounts, 2/3 use OTT services in Korea. And recently, Korean Ministry of Science and ICT, they just announced that $19.3 million to support the production of local broadcast content in a bid to boost the next generation media services, and 25% of the budget to support the short film videos and cross-media content to preserve and help diversity of the media ecosystem in Korea. So let me dive into substantial growth during COVID-19, K-drama's specific qualities. COVID-19 lockdown, as viewers ran out of shows to watch, many of them stumbled upon Korean dramas and have been hooked ever since. So COVID-19 became a chance for K-drama throughout all over the world. A wide range of genres, from science fiction and romance to horror and period, historical piece, and everything in between. So most consist of a finite number of episodes, often between 16 to 24, though some especially family-oriented and historical dramas run for 50 plus. And they are usually completed in a single season. It's a kind of different thing from American TV shows. So let me introduce Korean publishing house market as well. South Korea is the third largest market in Asia after China and Japan. 5% of French IP right abroad sales happened in Korea. French is third language of translations after Japanese and English. In 2020, 637 new French titles were translated in Korea. So French books represent about 15% of foreign book sales at Kyobo. Kyobo is equivalent to Funok, its number one bookstore group in South Korea. The genre most in demand for these translations by Korean publishers are, first thing is children's book, is 40% with 259 titles, and literature is almost 30% with almost 200 titles. The most widely read French authors remain Bernard Werber, Amélie Nothomb, and Guillaume Musso. In 2019, non-press revenue was nearly 4 trillion won, which is equivalent for 3 billion euros. 65,800 titles published in 2020, including 12,000 translations. So translations is about 20 or 19% according to the KPI. 60,000 publishers in Korea, but only 8,000 are active in 2019. The average print run per title is around 1,240 copies compared to 1,063 in 2019. The average price is stable around 12 euros. So let me dive more special potential value of K-drama. K-drama has high production value, which means that according to all these represented articles and survey, the production cost is much lower than American shows. And intense, bold, stimulating storylines build emotional connection between the characters and the audience. So Korean K-dramas is very PG-friendly, which means that nudity and sex are practically non-existent. K-dramas makes us feel less alone and often successfully tap into our shared human experiences and emotions. K-dramas on Netflix are dubbed and subbed in over 30 languages. So, and a true commercial and critical success of Parasite and Minari, it was in Oscar, Festival de Cannes, and Golden Globe, etc. So Netflix announced earlier this year investment of $500 million in Korean content. So it was before Squid Game and Hellbound. And Apple TV Plus, Disney Plus are following suit. The former adding at least two its original K-dramas, Dr. Brain by Kim Ji-eun and Pachinko. Pachinko is a novel by Lee Min-jin. Later this year and later working with local producers to create more Korean content. And six-part period crime series from director Yoon Jong-bin reportedly commanding a staggering $5 million per episode is a budget 160-fold increase over the average production cost than 21 years ago. So let me introduce more about the adaption and cultural influence from USA to South Korea. K-dramas continue to attract audience far and wide. Will the increased globalization impact the way they are made in the future? I think the answer is yes. The popularity of American crime drama like CSI series in South Korea has seemingly led to similar fare such as Stranger and Voice, both were hugely successful in domestic audiences. K-drama is really conversing in a language you don't understand. The production itself is often compelling enough to coax you into overcoming the 1-inch tall barrier of subtitles, as famously referenced by Korean filmmaker Bong Joon-ho. And just one thing is very interesting. Snowpiercer, Le Trunks Personnage, 2013 by Bong Joon-ho, initiated by pirated version. And Webtoons is the most wanted adaptation material in Korea. Example is DP, Hellbound, Dr. Brain, and Sweet Home. So let me introduce history and government support behind from 90s. Actually, South Korea has very long and military dictatorship since 60s. Maybe everyone, as you know, broadcasting infrastructures and allowing for programs to compete against each other. It was from since 90s. South Korea had only three public network channels in the early 90s, but the Korean government decided to allow another private network, SBS. It was private in 1991, and multiple cable channels in 1995. And in 1999, President Kim Dae-jung, a human rights activist, completely removed the censorship system for the film, which brought the renaissance of K-film in 2003. Why I'm saying this is renaissance in 2003, as you might know, Old Boy of Park Chan-wook, Memories of Murder of Bong Joon-ho, The Tale of Two Sisters by Kim Ji-eun, every three all this film just arrived in Korea in 2003. So in Korea, 2003 is like a magic year. And the K-drama craze reaching even the most isolated places in the world like North Korea. So in North Korea, bootleg copies of pirated version of South Korean dramas have been smuggled into our country since late 90s. And Korean pop culture is now viewed as a kind of growing threat to Kim Jong-un's power. And CJ E&M, and Lotte Megabox is a top three film distribution company in Korea, and they had their growth since early 2000. So let me introduce more about Asian market for K-drama and cinema and TPL for Korean companies. Actually, maybe as you know, South Korea is sort of an island, three sides, the seas, they're surrounded by the sea, and the north is really essentially like blocked by North Korea. So it is like an island with fairly limited natural resources. That's the reason that we try to invent something new and something innovative from nothing. And Japanese, Chinese consumers have been a huge part of the success of the Korean wave since early 90s and late 90s. And for example, if you want to have kind of Korean car advertisement, if you are Hyundai, they try to go to K-dramas for having this kind of advertisement. So Hyundai has traditionally advertised in China and Asia. They try to use K-dramas and films, a kind of cultural weapon. And that's the same thing for Samsung electronics products and many, many other products, including food and beverage as well. So it's kind of great insight for these K-dramas. And I'm not sure if you have any questions or more further questions, and you can ask me a little bit later. I will introduce the next speaker, Nina Zhong. Nina Zhong, elle est une directrice de la Seoul Film Commission. Elle est la charge d'affaires internationales.
Let me share my screen with you guys. Hi, I'm Nina Zhong, a Seoul Film Commission. So, Parasite, the first South Korean film to win the Palme d'Or and the first non-English language film to win the Academy Award for Best Picture. According to Netflix, Squid Game became the most watched Netflix series of all time. Korea is a country that produces a lot of films and series every year. So, the creators in Korea are always looking for a good story or a good source for their next movies and series. Today, I will briefly introduce you to the films and TV industry in Korea and tell you about the adaptation. And lastly, I will mention what we do and what we can do.
So as you can see here, in terms of the market size, Korea and France has very similar size market. So this is the admission. From 2016 to 2019, the Korean market was the fifth largest. Last year, due to the COVID-19, it ranked seventh. Here we can see again that the admission from both Korea and France are similar in terms of the market size. One important thing to note is that Korea watches more Korean movies than foreign movies. That's why we produce a lot of movies every year. While the data shown here in the graph for most countries shows the number of feature film produced, the Korean data shows the number of feature film released. Around 600 films were released last year. So there were several repeat screenings of movies though, but you can clearly see we produce a lot of movies. Let's move on to TV. In fact, it's difficult to compare the TV industry because the broadcasting system used vary a lot from country to country. I just want you to know that just like film industry, in terms of numbers, the TV industry in Korea and France are very similar. When it comes to the market size, the French market is a little bigger than the Korean market, but some numbers are exactly same as you can see here. In Korea, especially for TV content, we mostly watch local contents. The sales of production companies account for about 15% of all broadcasting and video industry sales. This rate is expected to increase significantly as global streaming services such as Netflix invest a lot to produce local Korean contents, as Naohi explained before. So that was my brief introduction to film and TV industry in Korea. Let's talk now about adaptation. I will start with successful foreign adaptations that worked very well in Korea and also all over the world. One example is The Handmaiden, directed by Park Chan-wook. The movie was well received by critics, but it was also a big hit. It grossed over $38 million worldwide. This movie is an adaptation of a British novel, Fingersmith. Old Boy is a work that made director Park Chan-wook known to the world. It is loosely based on a Japanese comic of the same name. The film won the Green Prix at the 2004 Cannes Film Festival and ranked the fifth on the list of the highest grossing films of 2003 in Korea. Snowpiercer is another example of one of Korea's most successful adaptations. It's an adaptation of the 1982 French comic. The movie received worldwide critical acclaim and became the second highest grossing film of 2013 in Korea. More than 9.3 million people watched this movie in Korea. The film, along with the original French graphic novel, was adapted into an American television show last year. It's the most successful adaptation of the French original. There are several movies and series based on French works. The film Will You Be There is based on the famous French novel of the same name by Guillaume Meissault. The Dangerous Liaison was made into a film twice and into a TV drama once. Untold Scandal is set in 18th century Korea during the Joseon Dynasty. The original story for a French nobleman was updated to a similar story about Korean aristocrats. The film was a major commercial success and became the fourth highest grossing domestic film of 2003. Another movie version of the Dangerous Liaison was a Korean and Chinese co-production. It was also made into a TV series. However, other examples such as a French movie Here and its adaptation The Beast, and the French movie Point Blank and its adaptation The Target weren't so successful. Not all adaptations worked well. Snowpiercer and Untold Scandal are successful cases. Director Bong Joon-ho brought only the concept of the original and turned it into a new story with new characters. Untold Scandal was praised for its authentic translation of the original works set in France, repurposed to fit 18th century Korea and Joseon Dynasty. French and Korean culture are different. Therefore, whether French works are reinterpreted well in Korea will sometimes determine the success or failure of the remake. Here are some more good examples of adaptations. If a story becomes a movie and does well, then a musical or a game adaptation may also come out later. Secretly Greatly is a webtoon, which was first made into film. The movie was a hit, and then later it was made into musical. Miseong Incomplete Life is a 2014 South Korean TV series based on a webtoon series of the same title. It was hugely popular, and later it was remade in Japan and China as a series. Along with The Gods is a webtoon and made into film. The movie along with The God was a huge box office hit across Asia. Later, it was made into musical and game. Based on a webtoon of the same name, Itaewon Class is a big hit series in Korea. Especially, it was very popular in Japan. There have been many movies and dramas based on novels, but as I mentioned now, a recent trend is an adaptation of webcomics. So introducing French graphic novels to Korea is an untapped market with great possibility. So now about Seoul-Film Commission. So Seoul is the capital of Korea, which means naturally it is the heart of Korea's film and TV industry. This is what Seoul Commission does. We support local industry and work as a liaison for international filmmakers who want to film in Seoul, Korea. We have a development support program for international projects set in Seoul. They are currently only for feature films, TV or web series or documentaries. But we are discussing a possibility of expanding them to include various forms of original contents. Because just like a Snowpiercer, a great idea or a great concept can be a fantastic novel, a wonderful graphic novel, a fabulous movie, and a terrific series. Lastly, I'd like to introduce the IP market in Korea. ACFM runs alongside the Busan International Film Festival, which happens every October. The EIP market is an international IP trading zone for various original content adaptable across multiple media platforms. This year, 10 Taiwanese and 7 Japanese original IPs were introduced to Korean filmmakers through the EIP market. As I mentioned earlier, I thought it would be fundamental to make a new support program for various films. I will definitely let you know through the French Embassy if we launch a new support program that can be useful for you in the future. Thank you for listening. Merci.
Thank you very much, Nina. It was really interesting and useful, helpful, because I think it's really based on your field experience and very concrete information. And thank you so much again. And on va aller vers Stéphane Martinet. Et il est responsable de la promotion internationale à Film Paris Région. Bonjour Stéphane.
Bonjour. Donc, je suis en charge de la promotion internationale chez Film Paris Région, qui est une commission du film. Une commission du film est classiquement en charge de la promotion de son territoire auprès des producteurs français, mais aussi et surtout auprès des producteurs étrangers. Nous leur faisons valoir que l'image animée a été inventée en France, que nous tournons en France depuis plus de 125 ans des œuvres qui sont dans un premier temps cinématographiques, ensuite audiovisuelles et bien entendu d'images animées, dessins animés et autres. Notre fonction est de faire valoir les ressources locales qui sont bien entendu les décors, les personnels techniques disponibles en France, mais aussi les dispositifs financiers qui permettent aux productions étrangères de venir tourner ici et ainsi bénéficier d'avantages particulièrement compétitifs par rapport au reste du monde. Donc, il existe deux dispositifs aujourd'hui, en attendant l'apparition des slides. Deux dispositifs aujourd'hui, un dispositif national et un dispositif régional propre à l'Île-de-France. Le dispositif national est classiquement un crédit d'impôt. Pourquoi vous parlez du crédit d'impôt aujourd'hui? Tout simplement parce que si l'idée est que vos ouvrages soient achetés par des productions coréennes comme étant des IPs, les tournages en conséquence de cette vente seraient optimiseraient la démarche dans le sens où ils se produiraient sur le sol français et encore mieux pour ce qui nous concerne sur le sol de l'Île-de-France. Et donc, l'idée est que vous puissiez convaincre ou en tout cas que vous ayez dans votre besace les arguments pour faire valoir que si une histoire paraît vraiment très française, eh bien, ma foi, le film ou la série peut bien être tourné qu'on est ici en France et qu'il y a des aides financières à cet effet. Aujourd'hui, cette aide est à hauteur de 30% sur toutes les dépenses effectuées en relation avec le tournage physique en France. Cela inclut des billets d'avion, des hôtels, pas de luxe, mais tout de même, cela inclut tout ce qui est nécessaire pour tourner en France. Cela inclut les salaires raisonnables des acteurs français. Si la production décide de faire sa post-production sur le sol français, alors le pourcentage de rabais monte à 40% sur l'ensemble des dépenses et pas simplement sur les dépenses de post-production ou d'effets spéciaux. Il faut néanmoins dépenser un minimum de 2 millions d'euros pour accéder à ces 40%, 2 millions d'euros sur la post-production ou les effets spéciaux. Sont éligibles les films de cinéma et d'animation, les unitaires de fiction, les séries télé, les travaux de post-production et d'effets spéciaux. Pour les films et les séries, un minimum de 5 jours de tournage est requis sur le sol français. Ensuite, il y a un plancher pour le minimum de dépenses de 250 000 euros ou 50% du budget total de l'œuvre qui est donc requis. L'œuvre doit répondre à des critères liés à la culture française. Donc, on doit y voir la France, donc principalement pour ce qui nous concerne. On doit y voir l'Île-de-France et Paris. On doit avoir une sorte de mix de langues dans le sens où certains des personnages doivent soit parler français, soit parler très mal la langue étrangère dans laquelle l'œuvre est tournée. Il doit y avoir des références culturelles à la France. Ça peut passer par des images d'œuvres, ça peut passer par l'évocation d'œuvres écrites ou d'œuvres filmées. Donc, tout ça peut être utilisé. C'est un fonds qui est largement utilisé. À ce jour, 3 œuvres coréennes ont fait appel à ce dispositif. Il est extrêmement confortable puisqu'il existe depuis une dizaine d'années dorénavant. C'est un argument extrêmement fort auprès des producteurs étrangers dès lors qu'ils souhaitent rester dans une grande indépendance. Et donc, nous allons voir avec la prochaine slide que les producteurs peuvent... peuvent faire appel à un fonds de soutien proposé par la région Île-de-France qui permet à des producteurs étrangers et français d'entrer en coproduction. À ce moment-là, 50% des dépenses effectuées en relation avec le tournage physique en France sont restituées à la production. C'est le producteur français qui gère le dossier. Généralement, il est celui qui va garder l'argent, mais en fait, l'argument, c'est que le tournage en France coûte 50% moins cher que la facture qui est présentée au titre des dépenses. Le producteur français, le coproducteur français, doit rester minoritaire, donc moins de 50%. Sont éligibles tous les types d'œuvres, cinéma, animation, unitaire de fiction, série, à partir du moment où les œuvres font plus de 60 minutes pour ce qui est des séries, par exemple. Il s'agit en fait de minutes cumulées entre plusieurs numéros d'une même série. Il n'y a pas d'obligation de tournage ou de fabrication en Île-de-France, dans le sens où le coproducteur français va apporter des fonds et donc du coup il va ensuite assurer la diffusion en France. Il n'y a pas d'obligation que le film soit tourné en français. Il y a un minimum néanmoins de dépenses sur le sol français dès lors qu'il y a dépenses en France. Donc, il y a un minimum de dépenses de 100 000 euros. Le budget maximal pris en compte est de 500 000 euros. Donc, le retour se situe entre 50 000 et 250 000 euros. L'œuvre doit répondre à un certain nombre de critères liés à la culture française, tout comme pour le crédit d'impôt international. À ce jour, ce dispositif n'a pas encore servi pour financer une œuvre de coproduction avec la Corée, mais étant donné le développement de la production coréenne, de la production internationale coréenne, inévitablement, ce dernier dispositif sera mobilisé par un producteur français qui entrera en relation avec un producteur coréen. La raison de notre présence lors de cette conférence, elle est assez simple à résumer. Si vos livres, vos œuvres sont vendues à des productions coréennes, il nous semble juste d'envisager de voir certaines de ces œuvres tourner sur le sol où éventuellement les histoires se déroulent. C'est un enjeu d'une certaine façon au titre de la culture française et en dérivé au titre d'une des premières activités économiques de notre pays qui est le tourisme. Donc, nous sommes à votre disposition pour vous accompagner. Vous voyez là mes coordonnées, mais vous pourrez bien entendu les obtenir dès lors que vous recevrez le dossier qui vous sera envoyé accompagnant cette conférence d'aujourd'hui. Donc, j'en ai terminé. Je vous remercie de votre attention et je rends la parole à Kim. À Adélaïde.
Merci beaucoup Stéphane, c'était vraiment une présentation très utile et on va passer vers Madame Hong Ji-young. Elle est une réalisatrice que je l'adore depuis toujours et c'est un honneur pour moi qu'elle soit là avec nous. Et elle a fait une adaptation de Guillaume Misso et donc on sera là avec Madame Hong Ji-young et aussi Bonnie YouTubeuse et interprète pour ces conversations.
네, 안녕하세요. 저는 홍지영 감독입니다.
Bonjour, je suis Hong Ji-young, la réalisatrice du film Olivier.
네, 이 컨퍼런스 제안을 받았을 때 제가 다섯 개의 소설에는 없지만 영화에는 제가 각색한 대사로 한번 설명을 드리면 어떨까 생각을 해봤습니다.
Donc aujourd'hui, ma présentation se compose de cinq parties avec des répliques significatives pour moi dans le film.
첫 번째 영화를 여는 그 중요한 대사 중에 프란 레보비츠라는 미국의 저널리스트가 한 말이 있어요. 삶은 잠들지 못할 때 벌어지는 일이다.
Donc, pour le début de mon film, j'ai choisi d'utiliser cette phrase de Madame Leibowitz. Donc, la vie, c'est d'avoir quelque chose à faire quand vous ne parvenez pas à dormir.
어쩌면 기억 미서와 저와의 만남은 그 잠 못 드는 밤에 어쩌다 집어든 책 한 권에서 시작됐는지도 모르겠습니다.
En fait, quand j'ai rencontré un roman de Guillaume Misso, je n'arrivais pas à dormir et j'ai voulu le livre. Et c'était comme un destin pour moi.
2007년 즈음에서 저희 한국에서는 기욤 미소 붐이 일었었는데요. 그때 다섯 권 정도가 한국어로 출간이 됐었어요.
En Corée du Sud, en 2007, il y avait une tendance, un grand boom des livres de Guillaume Misso. Et à cette époque, 5 livres de Guillaume Musson ont été traduits.
그 중에 2007년 당시에도 생생히 기억하고 있는데 만약 영화를 찍게 된다면 당신 거기 있어줄래요로 찍겠다라고 그 감상을 정리했었던 기억이 있습니다.
Donc, je me souviens très bien. Donc, à cette époque, quand je lisais des livres, je me suis dit si j'adaptais un roman au cinéma, ce serait toujours Seras-tu-là.
감독한테 있어서 새로운 아이템을 찾는데 책을 읽거나 여행을 가거나 혹은 전시를 보거나 등등의 역할들이 있는 그런 활동들을 하는데요. 항상 책을 가까이 하다 보니까 이런 소설가와의 만남은 굉장히 중요한 순간이기도 합니다. 인생에.
Quand j'essaie de trouver une idée pour un film, donc en tant que réalisatrice, donc pour nous, on essaie de voyager ou lire des livres ou d'aller aller à une exposition. Donc ce moment-là, quand j'ai trouvé les romans de Guillaume Musso, c'était un moment très précieux pour moi.
그럼 왜 기욤 미소, 그 많은 소설가 중에 기욤 미소였는지가 궁금할 것 같아요. 제가 취한 이 장을 설명하는 데 대사는 일리나라는 여자 주인공이 사람이나 동물이나 똑같아 애정을 갖고 보면 뭘 원하는지 알 수 있어요. 그 애정을 갖고 보면 이라는 측면인 것 같아요.
Donc dans le film, Elena, il y a un dialogue pour Elena. Les humains et les animaux sont tous les mêmes. Avec un peu d'affection, tu sais ce qu'ils veulent. Donc pour moi, je pense que c'est très important d'avoir d'affection. Pour quelqu'un et c'est comme ça que j'ai rencontré Guillaume Musso avec d'affection.
단지 기욤 미소가 세계적인 베스트셀러였고 그러므로 작품성이나 대중성이라는 측면에서 검증받은 소설가여서 취한 건 아니었어요.
La raison pour laquelle j'ai choisi Monsieur Guillaume, c'était pas seulement que qu'il est un écrivain populaire et qui est nommé.
첫 번째 이유는 소설을 읽었을 때 아, 그는 시네필이구나 라는 필이 왔습니다.
Donc ma première raison c'est parce que je pensais que Guillaume Musso était un grand cinéphile.
많은 사람들이 빠른 이야기 전개나 영화적인 서사 구조를 그의 소설 특징으로 꼽곤 하는데요. 저는 대단히 훌륭한 편집자로서의 그의 면모를 보았습니다.
Donc beaucoup de gens disent que Guillaume Musso le texte le style de texte de Guillaume Musso. Donc, ils ont un style visuel ou cinématographique comme un film. Mais moi, je pense qu'il est quelqu'un qui comprend le montage et aussi la structure d'un film.
두 번째는 굉장히 특이하게 장르를 엮는 개척자라는 생각이 들었어요.
Ensuite, je pense qu'il est vraiment quelqu'un qui sait jongler avec les genres et qui a créé un genre nouveau.
모든 사람의 인생에 있어서 로망이라고 할 수 있는 러브 스토리와 장르적 재미를 더할 수 있는 스릴러를 결합한 거죠.
Donc ce qu'il a fait, il a mélangé entre le genre romantique et aussi le thriller.
특히 판타지를 많이 들여오는데 타임슬립 같은 소재는 굉장히 영화적이었어요.
Ensuite, il ajoute aussi des éléments du genre fantastique, comme il a utilisé le dispositif cinématographique, le laps de temps.
세 번째 이유가 있습니다. 미국을 주요 배경으로 쓰는 프랑스 소설가라는 점인데요. 영화 감독도 어쩌면 미지의 세계를 영화 속에서 구현하는 사람인데, 그가 스스로를 낯설게 하는 방식으로 소설을 쓴다는 게 굉장히 매력적이었습니다.
Ce qui est attirant des romans de Guillaume Musso, c'est qu'il a choisi les États-Unis pour le décor de ses romans. Donc, c'est vrai que pour les réalisateurs et les réalisatrices, on essaie de faire un nouveau défi. Et je pense que cette approche est similaire avec le travail d'un réalisateur.
아마도 과정이 궁금하실 것 같아요. 그걸 계약 전이랑 계약 후 이렇게 두 가지 파트로 나눠서 설명을 드릴까 합니다.
Je pensais que vous seriez curieux du processus de cette adaptation, donc j'ai distingué ce processus entre avant de signer le contrat et après la signature du contrat.
사실 영화 속에서 굉장히 많은 것을 궁금해하는 젊은 엘리엇에게 나이 든 엘리엇이 하는 말이거든요. 뭐가 그렇게 궁금하니? 살다 보면 다 알게 될 것들인데. 여러분들에게 그렇지만 소스를 알려드리겠습니다.
Donc, dans le film, le futur Elliot dit au jeune Elliot « Pourquoi êtes-vous si curieux? Vous saurez tout avec le temps. » Donc, je pensais que vous, en tant qu'éditeur et cinéaste, pourriez être curieux de mon processus. Donc, voilà, je vous présente maintenant.
2007년에 처음 소설을 읽고 에이전시로부터 출판사 에이전시로부터 소설 영화 제안을 받은 건 6년이 지난 2013년이었어요.
Après avoir lu les romans de Guillaume Musso en 2007 et après 6 ans en 2013, une maison d'édition m'a proposé de faire cette adaptation cinématographique.
같은 해 11월에 결국 프랑스에서 영화사 대표 그리고 프랑스 출판 대표 그리고 기욤 미소까지 만났습니다.
Donc en novembre 2013, j'avais un rendez-vous avec Guillaume Musso et la société de production et les maisons d'édition.
첫날 미팅에서의 에피소드를 하나 있는데 그때가 2013년이었고 극장에 헝거 게임 캐칭 파이어라는 작품이 걸려 있을 때였어요.
Donc en fait, je vous raconte une anecdote. Donc, en 2013, Hunger Games de Catching Fire était à l'affiche.
아시다시피 그건 할리우드의 블록버스터였고 공교롭게도 그때 저의 세 번째 작품인 결혼 전야 Marriage Vow라는 작품을 같이 개봉하고 있었는데 결국 제가 한국에서 더 스코어에서 앞섰습니다.
Donc, comme vous le savez, Hunger Games 2 est un film, un blockbuster hollywoodien. Et au même moment, mon troisième film, qui s'appelle Marriage Blue, était à l'affiche. Donc, Hunger Games 2 était le film concurrent.
원작자인 기욤 미소에게 설득 포인트가 됐던 것 같아요. 작은 사랑 이야기인 듯하지만 경쟁력이 있으니 한국의 영화 자본으로 함께 한번 영화를 만들어 보자. 영화를 허락해 달라.
Donc mon troisième film a dépassé Hunger Games et donc je pense que c'était moins compliqué de persuader de cette adaptation lors de notre premier rendez-vous. Donc comme ça bien qu'on n'a pas tourné avec un budget hollywoodien, on avait une force. Donc je pense que on a prouvé ce point-là.
여기서 문화적 차이가 있는데 사실 일의 스피드의 차이가 꽤 커요. 한국의 경우는 계약서를 주고받고 아주 빠르게 검토를 하는데 계약 체결까지 1년이 걸렸습니다.
Ici aussi, j'ai vraiment pu voir la différence culturelle et aussi la différence dans le rythme et la vitesse du processus parce que cela nous a pris un an pour que le contrat définitif soit signé.
자, 계약 후에 이제 넘어가면 시나리오를 불어로 번역해서 원작자에게 전달하고
Donc après la signature du contrat définitif, on a envoyé le scénario traduit à l'auteur original.
캐스팅, 크랭크업 모든 계획들을 함께 공유하고 마지막 완본까지 전달을 했습니다.
On a aussi partagé le planning de notre casting, le début et la fin du tournage et aussi la sortie du film.
굉장히 중요한 계약의 포인트가 있습니다. 즉 원작의 내용을 얼마나 유지할 것인가에 대한 부분입니다.
Ce qui est un point très important, c'est que comment maintenir, enfin trouver l'équilibre entre l'histoire originale et des modifications.
제가 이 섹션에서 설명하고 싶은 것처럼 영화 속 중요한 그 주연 엘리엇이 이런 말을 합니다. 중요한 건 이야기 자체가 아니냐고, 꼭 해피엔딩이어야 하냐고.
Dans le film, Elliot dit pourquoi faut-il toujours que ce soit une fin heureuse qui compte, c'est l'histoire.
그런 면에서 기욤 미소가 원작을 그 바꾸는 거에 굉장히 큰 동의를 해줬다고 생각이 들어요. 중요한 건 이야기 자체이고 영화 자체이니까요.
Je pense que comme cet dialogue Guillaume Musso m'a vraiment donné de la liberté pour modifier, pour adapter mon film. parce que ce qui compte, c'est l'histoire.
첫 번째, 두 번째, 세 번째를 함께 다 얘기하면 첫 번째는 주인공, 여자 주인공의 직업과 사건을 죽음의 사인을 바꾼 것입니다.
D'abord, ce que j'ai modifié, c'est le métier et le suicide d'Elena dans le livre.
네, 큰 변화일 수 있는데 일리나라는 캐릭터가 한국에서는 그 동물 조연사로 바뀌고 그리고 자살이 아닌 사고사로 바뀌게 되죠.
Je pense que c'est un grand changement parce que dans le film, le métier d'Elena est dompteuse des animaux marins. Et ensuite, elle ne se suicide pas dans le film, elle trouve la mort dans un accident.
어떤 면에서 세계관의 변화라고도 이룰 수 있는 좀 큰 변화였는데 충분히 용인해 줬습니다.
Je pense que j'ai un peu modifié la vision du monde de ce livre, mais Guillaume Meissot a accepté.
두 번째는 굉장한 양의 소설을 압축하는 과정에서 인물들을 압축했다는 겁니다.
Mon deuxième point, c'est que en faisant raccourcir un livre, j'ai choisi de supprimer un rôle.
세 번째는 그 영화에서 소설에서 굉장히 중요한 강아지가 있는데 영어로 Stranger라는 이름을 갖고 있거든요. 근데 그게 한국에서 왔을 때 이방인이라는 굉장히 보통은 쓰지 않는 언어였기 때문에 감자라는 구어체로 바꾸는 변화가 있었습니다.
Ensuite, j'ai aussi changé le nom de chien qui a joué un rôle important dans le film. Alors dans la version anglaise, le nom de chien était Stranger, mais ça sonnait un peu bizarre quand on change en coréen, quand on traduit en coréen. Donc, j'ai changé le nom du chien en pomme de terre, Kamja en coréen.
무엇보다 기욤 미소가 이 저희 영화 속에서 주인공이었던 김윤석 배우를 이미 알고 있었고 그에 대한 호감도 한몫을 한 것 같습니다.
Donc Guillaume Meissot a déjà connu l'acteur Kim Yun-seok qui a joué le rôle d'Eliot et il a déjà apprécié cet acteur.
이 책에서 굉장히 중요한 건 어떤 제약도 없었다는 것. 이게 포인트입니다.
Ce qui est très important, pour moi, quand j'ai fait cette adaptation, il n'y avait pas de restriction.
마지막에 둘이 회호를 하면서 30년 만에 우리 얼마나 떨어져 있었지? 라는 엘리엇의 말을 대신했습니다.
Donc à la fin, j'ai utilisé cette dialogue. Combien de temps avons-nous été séparés? C'était le dialogue entre Elliot et Elena et ils se rencontrent après 30 ans.
2017년 4월에 35회 브뤼셀 국제 판타스틱 영화제에서 기욤 미소를 특별히 만날 수가 있었는데요.
En 2017, en avril, j'ai rencontré Guillaume Meissot au 35e festival international du film fantastique à Bruxelles.
이미 편집자와 부인은 스크린을 통해서 영화를 본 상태였고 기욤 미소는 아직 본 상태가 아니었습니다.
Donc sa femme et le monteur ont déjà vu le film, mais par contre Guillaume Meissot m'a dit qu'il n'avait pas le temps de regarder mon film.
아주 긴장되고 불편한 자리였는데요. 원작자와 영화를 함께 본다는 것.
Donc j'étais un peu mal à l'aise de voir le film avec l'auteur original, enfin à l'occasion de ce festival.
영화 상영 이후에 기욤이 했던 말이 정확히 기억이 납니다.
Je me souviens ce qu'il m'a dit après la projection du film.
영화를 처음 볼 때는 너무 다른 이야기가 아닌가라고 의심했었다고.
Au début, il avait un doute. Il pensait que c'était un autre film.
그러나 영화 중간 몇 번 나를 움직였고 그래서 몇 번 울 뻔했다고.
Et au milieu du film, il a dit le film m'a vraiment touché, donc j'ai presque pleuré.
결국 우리는 소설로 영화로 같은 이야기를 한 것 같다고.
Donc à la fin, les histoires se sont vraiment croisées. Donc ceci est dit par Guillaume Meissot après la projection du film.
영화가 아주 만족스러웠다는 마지막 말을 남기면서 당신의 아이폰을 막 뒤져서 내일이라는 당신의 소설을 그 즉시 저한테 영화화를 제안했어요.
Donc comme après il m'a donné un grand compliment et ensuite il m'a proposé de faire un autre film adapté de son livre qui s'appelle Demain.
그 제안만으로 충분히 칭찬을 받은 것 같아서 굉장히 만족스러운 만남이었습니다.
Et je pense que cette proposition était le plus grand compliment et j'étais très contente.
결국 저의 경험으로 이 경험이 말해주는 세 가지 정도가 있을 것 같아요.
Je pense que, en basant sur cette expérience, je vais choisir trois points qui sont importants.
첫 번째는 서로의 소설과 영화를 그것인 채로 존중해줬다는 겁니다.
네, 감독님 한 번 다시 말씀해 주세요. 안 들렸어요.
소설과 영화인 채로 그대로 서로를 존중해줬다는 것.
Donc le premier point, Guillaume Musso a vraiment accepté la différence d'une œuvre littéraire et d'un film.
제가 기욤 미소 소설을 영화화한다고 했을 때 가장 많이 받았던 질문이 원작과 비교될까봐 부담스럽지 않냐는 거였습니다.
Beaucoup de gens m'ont posé cette question. Ce serait un grand fardeau de faire adapter un roman de Guillaume Musso.
그때마다 전 항상 같은 대답을 했었던 것 같아요. 다른 장르라고.
Et ma réponse était toujours pareille. Non, le film et une œuvre littéraire, ce sont des différents genres.
두 번째는 불가능한 걸 같았던 조합을 했던 도전 같은 겁니다. 엄두내는 것.
Ensuite, je pense que c'était un défi assez difficile et qui semblait impossible au début.
우리 사이에는 언어도 문화도 심지어 소설이 한국에 소개되는 시간차도 있었습니다.
죄송합니다. 감독님 한 번 더 말씀해 주세요.
우리 사이에는 언어의 경계, 문화의 경계, 그리고 한국으로 이 문화가 전달되는 데서의 시간까지도 경계가 있었다.
Donc entre moi et Guillaume Musso, il y avait toujours des limites linguistiques, culturelles et aussi du temps.
그럼에도 불구하고 이 불가능한 조합은 이루어졌습니다.
Malgré cette combinaison et cette tâche difficile, on a réalisé ce projet.
세 번째 마지막은 서로 약속을 정확히 지켰다는 겁니다.
Le troisième point, c'est qu'on a respecté notre promesse.
기욤 미소가 원했던 건 소설이 이야기하는 바가 한국화되더라도 지켜줬으면 좋겠다라는 것.
Guillaume Musso m'a dit, même si je modifie cette œuvre littéraire à la coréenne, j'espère que vous ne toucherez pas vraiment la substance.
저는 영화를 찍는 내내 기욤 미소의 소설을 계속 읽었습니다. 정말 원하는 이야기를 제가 담고 있는지를 확인했었던 거죠.
Donc, j'ai dû lire les livres de Guillaume Musso plusieurs fois pendant le tournage pour bien comprendre.
결국 훌륭한 전예가 된 것 같아서 뿌듯하고 다음 내일이 제안했던 내일이 만들어질 수 있을지는 기대해 주십시오.
Donc, j'étais très contente avec ma première adaptation cinématographique avec ce Ratula et ouais, j'espère que je peux suivre mon deuxième projet avec le roman demain.
Merci beaucoup.
Oui, merci beaucoup pour madame et aussi bonne nuit pour l'interprétation. Il y a vraiment des questions qui nous arrivent. 저희 질문이 들어왔습니다. 약간 시간이 모자라기 때문에 제가 조금 빨리 읽겠습니다. Si ce n'est pas en discret, est-ce que les droits de remake du film Suratula ont aussi été décidés ou bien est-ce qu'un projet coréen seulement? 홍지영 감독님께 이제 온 질문인데요. 이 당신 거기 있어줄래요에 대한 이 리메이크 판권이 오로지 한국에만 허락이 되었는지 그 질문입니다.
네, 맞습니다. 이후에 한국에서의 성공을 두고 중국에서 똑같이 그걸 사고 싶어 했는데 기움이 거절했습니다.
Bah oui, seulement c'était en Corée. Alors, la Chine a demandé de faire encore reprise pour eux, mais Guillaume a refusé de faire ça.
그리고 한국에 이전에 저한테 제안하기 전에 헐리우드에서 이미 그 판권 제안을 했었는데 거절했다고 들었습니다.
Même avant, Madame Hong, il y a pas mal de l'offre de Hollywoodien, mais Guillaume a toujours refusé. Donc, c'était seulement pour le projet coréen. Donc, on va passer à la deuxième question. La deuxième question, c'est Madame Hong aimerait-elle réaliser d'autres adaptations de livres français ou d'œuvres françaises de même manière générale? 다시 홍지영 감독님께 또 오는 질문인데요. 이 소설 말고도 뭔가 다른 어떤 프랑스 소설이나 문학 작품이나 어떤 것이든 이제 또 각색을 한 번 더 하실 계획이 있는지 그리고 또 뭐 다른 프랑스 작품에 대한 어떤 생각이 있으신지 이런 질문이네요.
항상 소설에 대한 귀는 열려 있고 그리고 제가 아마 2년 정도 외국 생활을 파리에서 했던 게 큰 영향을 주는 것 같습니다. 그래서 많은 작가들을 여전히 섭렵하고 있고 네, 그렇습니다.
Mais en fait, Madame Hong, quand elle était plus jeune, elle a passé 12 ans à Paris. Donc, c'est une expérience essentielle de sa vie. Et donc, pour elle, ses oreilles sont toujours ouvertes pour les romans français. Donc, je pense qu'il y a beaucoup de potentiel attente pour le futur. Et je pense que c'était une conférence aussi, la suite du cas est très intéressante. Hein. Et alors, on va passer vers une table ronde participée par Kim Justin Byung-in. Il est un romancier scénariste, président de la Guilde des scénaristes sud-coréennes. Et aussi, Lee Kyung-mi, elle est une réalisatrice et aussi scénariste. Lee Kyung-mi est aussi vraiment mon préféré depuis tout au début de sa carrière. Et voilà, Justin, il va commencer d'abord. Kim Byung-in 선생님, 시작해 주시면 됩니다.
Hi everyone, this is Justin Byung-in Kim. Very nice to meet you, and I'm very glad to hear that this is happening. That France is very famous for a long time history of literature, and then great imaginations, and then Korea is very these days very hot in audiovisual world. So connecting two worlds would be very interesting idea. And I hope this attempt is come to fruition. So wishing that, I'd like to introduce today two cases that has been adaptation into screen. To be more specific, it was one is on screen, and the other one is on Netflix series. One is a successful case and one is a little bit of a failure case. The reason why I'm presenting these two cases is that to give you a hint that what could be absolutely necessary when adapting a French novel into Korean audiovisual work. I think director Hong covered a pretty essential aspect of it. And I agree a lot about what she said. On top of that, I think these cases will give you more insight. Okay, the first case is DP. It is a successful case. It is DP is basically Defector Pursuit. It is about military police story. So it is based on this DP webtoon. This when you see on the left hand side, this is original web comics. And this is about a military police guy who is chasing after the runaway soldiers. So it was okay, successful webtoon. And then the director of this DP series saw this webtoon a long time ago, and he fell in love with this comic book. It's not actually a book; it's on the website, so it's a webtoon. And then he contacted this the author of web comics, and then suggested that he wanted to make this into a TV series. And then surprisingly, he's a writer director, and then he suggested that why don't you, the author of the webtoon, participate as a screenwriter? So the webtoon author and the director co-wrote the script. That's very rare case, but the director writer was had a real high respect of this webtoon, he just invited him on. So the webtoon author actually jumped in, and then they discussed many things, and then they actually agreed to make two very important changes. One is the guy here is the main guy. On the webtoon, he is a senior guy. He is a corporate, so he is the team leader of the pursuit team, and then he gives a lot of order to his junior guy. So he in the webtoon, he is a senior. This guy is senior, and then he has a junior guy underneath him. But they decided to change that as the main guy become a new guy. He is a very fresh to the military. He meets this guy in the blue. He is a senior guy, is a new character, which he was not in the webtoon, but they agreed to create this guy. And then this guy is leading this main character. So that's quite significant change. But they agreed to make this change because the director persuaded this webtoon author that for film or for TV series, it is important to invite people into the character. And it's better to show the character with when he was a civilian, and then he is conscripted to military service, and he just goes into the military, becomes military police. And he is a very, very fresh guy. And that would be a very interesting start. And then a lot of audience will relate to the main character. That was the reason of the director writer. So webtoon author listened to that, and then he thought, well, that's a great idea. So they just changed this, agreed to change that. I think that's just amazing. So I think also director Hong mentioned, but I think they could agree to this kind of big change because at the end of the day, it is about message. The message of DP, both webtoon and TV series, is that this humanitarian cause. In Korea, sadly, there was a lot of humanitarian activities happening in the base. A lot of harassment, a lot of abusement. So that has become a big social issue. And what these two media, the contents are trying to say is basically the same. Humans should be treated better. Humans are very precious being, no matter how what kind of rank they have, and no matter what kind of background they have. So I believe the director writer and then the author of this webtoon connected in that message. So as long as the message is the same, they can make changes according to its best fit to the media. So I think that's why they could be successful. The next case is actually my case. I wrote, it's kind of a failure case. I first wrote a script myself, and then this is based on a fact, historical fact, that two or three people of Korean were discovered in France, Normandy Beach. During World War II, when American attacked the German territory at that time, they discovered these Koreans wearing German uniform, fighting against them. And I wrote a script based on the historical fact that how could they end up being there? What kind of life they had to pass through to get there? So I imagined that one could be Japanese and one could be Korean. That was the beginning of the story. So they were both rival in Korea, because at the time Korea was colony of Japan. And then as they go through this big journey, war after war, they become friends. So they started as a foe, but that ends up being friends. That was the basic storyline. So it is about bromance. So when I was writing this story into a script, my message, what I want to achieve through this story was that I want to make a reconciliation between Korea and Japan. So it was very important that this story is well accepted in Japan too. But there is very complicated historical issue. So I had to be very careful not to rub the Japanese in the wrong direction. So all those thoughts was incorporated into the script. And then the Warner Brothers wrote the script and they really loved it. So they wanted to make it. And then Director Kang was invited to the project. And then Director Kang started to change the script. During the process, he didn't really listen to me. I mean, as a writer, I had a clear message that I wanted to deliver to the world through this work, but he didn't pay attention to that. And he just changed whatever he wanted to. And then I saw the result and I didn't really like it. I thought it was a really dangerous attempt. It's not only because he changed it, but because message is not consistent. For me, as I told you before, having this story accepted by Japanese is equally important that it is accepted by Koreans. But his strategy was different. His strategy was make a big success in Korea, and then Japanese market is secondary, is a bonus. So to him, Korean audience was more important than Japanese audience. So he didn't care about Japanese actually. So he just tried to make a relationship between Japanese Korea is really, really bad. I mean, the Japanese were treating Koreans really, really bad. Maybe that's true, but it should be careful to show it to Japanese market, but his strategy was just different. So my attempts, my basic message, underlying message was damaged in that way. So I told him several times that if you change it that way, I suspect that it's not gonna work both in Korea and nor in Japan. Because in Korea, we have seen so many cases of this Japanese brutal oppression of Korean people during the colonial time. So I don't think it's gonna work both countries. But he just was just too big director, so he just walked his way. When I was watching him changing the script like that, I had a bad feeling about that. So I just decided to write a novel based on my original script. So the novel was written and published before the movie was released. So it was a parallel process. So director was making movie and I was writing a novel at the same time. The novel was published like 5 weeks earlier than the movie release day. And the book was really well received. And I was very grateful too. But when the movie was released, the movie was not successful both in Korea and Japan. So that was very regrettable experience. This is same message. When French author is trying to make their book adapted in Korean audiovisual world, I think we will bump into the same issue. But the core issue is the same as Director Hong has experienced. Every author has the same thing. I mean, even though the book is very long, you have a very clear one message that you want to tell to the world, right? It's very, very clear. As long as the Korean audiovisual creator and the French author has that common understanding, I think based on the common understanding, you can change pretty freely as long as they connect in that aspect. But if they don't really understand, if the Korean adapters doesn't really understand French author's deep meaning and deep message or deep intention of creating the book, it can be very bad experience. That's it. Thank you.
Merci beaucoup, Justine. C'était vraiment une histoire très intéressante et aussi vous avez ramené deux exemplaires pour nous. Donc, à la fois grand succès, à la fois moins grand succès. J'aime pas le mot échec, mais en tout cas, on va passer vers Madame Lee Kyung-mi et elle va parler en coréen et après je vais traduire en anglais pour elle. Lee Kyung-mi 감독님, 말씀 주십시오.
안녕하세요. 들리나요?
네, 잘 들립니다.
네, 안녕하세요. 저는 이경미 감독입니다.
Hello, my name is 경미 Lee. I'm filmmaker.
이렇게 홍지영 감독님 만나 뵙게 돼서 정말 반갑고 김병희 작가님 아프지만 아픈 이야기도 잘 들었습니다. 저는 작가이면서 감독이다 보니까 김병희 작가님의 말씀이 여러모로 조금 뼈 아프게 저도 느껴지는 부분들이 있었습니다.
Such a great pleasure to catch up with Madam Hong here and also Justin Byung-in Kim as a writer and filmmaker at the same time. I'm very happy, not just happy, I'm very connected to Justin's story because he just get through all this success and failure at the same time. It was touching.
예, 왜냐하면 그러니까 그 의미가 뭐냐면 저는 감독이기도 하지만 저 또한 원작을 가지고 작가로서도 작업을 하다 보니까 원작자로서는 자기의 작품이 다른 작가를 통해서 한번 거쳐질 때 그것에 대해서 어떤 기분을 가지게 될까에 대해서 늘 생각하다 보니 김병희 작가님의 이야기가 많이 와닿았습니다.
As a scenario writer, I'm also very concentrated on bringing all these messages from original stories. So it's also my focus and my concentration. That's the reason that the Byung-in, Justin Byung-in Kim's story was very touching for me.
저는 오늘 제가 한 작업 중에 원작을 가지고 각색을 해서 작품을 만든 경우 저의 경험에 대해서 간단하게 말씀드리겠습니다.
I'm going to talk about my own experience about adaptation based on this original novel.
제가 작업에 참여한 작품 중에 아직 영상화가 안 된 작품은 도널드 웨스트레이크 소설가의 X라는 소설입니다. 박찬욱 감독님의 작품이고 저는 작가로 참여했습니다.
Actually, I have one adaptation. It was before becoming a film. It's a Donald Blake.
Donald Westlake.
Donald Westlake X, also remade by Park Chan-wook, and the original film was. Costa Gavras.
Yes, right.
Yes.
Yeah. 코스타 가브라스 감독님에 의해서 한번 프랑스 영화로 만들어졌었죠.
It was made by Costa Gavras into French film.
예, 저에게 있어서는 그것이 각색 원작을 가지고 영상화하는 작업을 각본화하는 작업을 한 첫 작품이었는데.
Actually, it was my very first ever experience to adapt from original story into a film scenario.
제 작품이 아니고 만들어지지 않은 작품이라서 자세한 이야기는 할 수 없지만.
It was not my film, and it was before made into cinema, so I can't speak really many things about this film.
인상 깊었던 과정은. 외국 소설이다 보니 그 나라의 환경을 그대로 전달할 수는 없고 그 이야기를 한국의 배경에 맞추어서 다시 만들어가는 점이 인상 깊었습니다.
Most impressive thing is that it was a foreign novel, so I need to adapt into this local in Korea. So localization is very important.
그리고 원작 소설을 영상화하는 작업은 글로 써져 있는 것을 그대로 옮기는 것이 아니라 작가가 감독이 감독이자 각본가가 그 원작 소설을 바탕으로 영감을 받아서 새롭게 해석하는 작업이라는 생각을 그때 처음 했습니다.
So for me, adaptation doesn't mean that literally visualized all this written phrase in the book. It was a kind of new interpretation and a new invention. So what we understand from the book.
그래서 그 작업을 그러니까 그 DX를 각본 작업을 한 뒤에 그 전에는 계속 오리지널 스크립트를 써왔다가 저도 제 다음 작품으로 원작 소설이 원작 소설을 based on novel로 작업을 해보고 싶다는 생각을 했습니다.
So after this experience with the apps. I decided to do my upcoming new project, which is based on the novel. Before, I just worked on all original scenarios.
그래서 한 2년 이상 여러 나라의 소설들의 판권을 섭외하는 일을 시도했었습니다.
So more 2 years, I have been researching all over the world for finding a right IPs.
그 중에는 프랑스 소설도 있습니다.
Among them, there are some French novels as well.
우연히도 그 참석자분들의 명단에 바로 그 출판사가 있어서 반가웠습니다.
Actually, I'm very happy to discover the publisher's name that I just picked up at that time for the adaptation.
지금 여기에 계시는지 안 계시는지는 잘 모르겠는데 출판사가 알빈 미셸?
알방 미셸랑. It was Alban
Michel. Yeah, Alban Michel 출판사 측에 피에르 르메트르 소설가의 알렉스라는 소설을 의뢰했었죠.
It was Lemaitre by
Pierre Lemaitre.
Pierre Lemaitre. Yes.
소설 타이틀이 Alex.
The title was Alex.
그 당시에 판권이 이미 팔린 상태였고 영화화 된다는 기사까지 떴지만 그 이후에는 소식을 듣지 못했습니다.
Actually, at that time, IP was already sold, and then I got some articles about that it will be a film very soon, but I have no idea about the future news.
As far as I remember, that film director was French, maybe French. It is not clear, but yeah. So yeah, 그냥 혹시나 판권이 지금 available 하다면.
If still this novel's IP is available or not, at that time I remember that the French director will make this novel into film, but I'd like to figure out if IP is still available or not.
예, 그다음 제가 작업한 다음 작품에 대해서 잠깐 또 설명드리겠습니다.
So I'm going to explain more about my work of adaptations.
작년에 넷플릭스 시리즈로 공개됐습니다. 제목은 The School Nurse Fire.
It was drama made by Netflix originals. The title was The School Nurse Files.
한국 소설 원작 소설은 한국 소설가 정세랑 작가님의 보건 교사 안은영이라는 소설을 원작으로 가지고 있습니다.
Actually, it was based on novel written by 정세랑, and the Korean title is 보건 교사 안은영.
제가 그 소설로 다음 작품을 결정한 이유는.
The reason why I picked up this novel.
오리지널 스크립트를 더 이상 쓰고 싶지 않았고.
I can't stand write more original scenario by myself.
너무 고통스러운 일이에요.
It's painful.
그리고 원작 소설이 제가 저 혼자서는 결코 상상할 수 없는 이야기라는 점이 매력적이었습니다.
And the original novel is the story that I ever imagined by myself.
저는 평소 다크하고 크루얼한 이야기에 흥미를 느끼는 편인데 보건교사 아는 형은 그와 정반대에 있습니다.
I'm very interested with some dark and very peaceful story normally, but this novel is based on a kind of colorful and bright story.
그래서 이왕이면은 원작 소설을 나 혼자로서는 도저히 만들어낼 수 없는 이야기를 내가 잘할지 못할지 확신이 서지 않는 그런 세계를 한번 경험해보는 것도 재미있겠다는 생각이 들었습니다.
So I don't like to experience the world that I'm going to I'm going to be successful or be a failure, but kind of a story based on that I can't imagine by myself. I try to, I mean, challenge by myself.
Something I was very interested in, very exciting imaginations. And so 제가 각본 작업을 하면서 굉장히 재미있었던 점은 원작자가 이 이야기를 만든 원작자의 머릿속을 상상하는 일이었습니다.
For me, the adaptation is that to imagine inside of the writer who wrote this original novel.
글을 쓰다 보면 모든 것들을 의미하고 상징하고 계획한다고들 생각하지만 많이 글을 써보신 분들도 계실 텐데 이해하시겠지만은 때로는 내가 쓰는 것이 무엇인지 일일이 설명할 수 없는 어떤 모멘트들이 있습니다.
Sometimes while I'm writing something that I can't explain every single element in the story.
그런 작가의 그 무의식의 상징들을 해석하고 그것을 비주얼라이징 하는 것이 굉장히 재미있었습니다.
So I want to interpret and also make the sense of the symbols that writer wrote into her novel.
그리고 The School Nurse File 같은 경우는 원작자와 제가 각본을 같이 크레딧이 올라가 있습니다.
And I wrote the scenario with the original novelist Jung Se-rang as a co-scenarist.
원작자와 같이 각본 작업을 하는 것은 굉장히 흥미롭기도 하지만 또 고통스럽기도 합니다.
It's very interesting to share my work with original story writer, but it's also painful.
하지만 다음 작품도 원작 소설이 있었으면 좋겠습니다.
However, I hope that my next project will have also the co-writer original story based scenario.
근데 판권을 해외 판권을 구매하는 것이 굉장히 어려운 일이라는 것을 저는 수십 편의 작품을 시도했다가 실패해 본 경험이 있어서 홍지영 감독님 정말 부럽습니다.
I'm very jealous, Madam Hong, because by my experience that it's very difficult to buy a purchase foreign IPs for making a film.
그리고 저는 지금 그토록 원작 소설을 바랬지만 오리지널 스크립트를 쓰고 있습니다.
So right now, even if I really eagerly want to have this original based story, but now I'm writing by myself my original scenario.
Yeah, I'm in the hell now. Thank you.
Merci beaucoup. Merci Madame Gyeongmi, et c'était vraiment très intéressante et aussi à la fois aussi très touchante. Et j'apprécie beaucoup que vous avez parlé tellement le ton très honnête et c'était vraiment très émouvant pour moi. 이경미 감독님 이렇게 솔직하고 재밌는 이야기 들려주셔서 무척 감사합니다.
Alors, moi, je vais commencer la première question pour Madame Hong. Hong Jeong 감독님, 제가 질문이 안 나온 것 같아서 제가 먼저 하나만 여쭤보겠습니다. 강아지 이름이 감자로 스트레인저에서 감자 됐잖아요. 근데 한국에서 이게 음식 이름을 강아지나 고양이한테 되게 많이 주잖아요. 그런 배경이 있는 걸까요?
네, 굉장히 한국적인 각색을 하는 게 어쨌든 주요한 저의 임무였고 그러다 보니까 예를 들면 포도농장을 하게 되는 매트 절친이 있는데 그 포도농장을 제가 귤농장으로 바꾸거나 한라봉, 그러니까 제주도에만 생산되는 그런 귤, 뭐 이런 식으로 한국적 각색을 할 수밖에 없었어요. 그리고 재미있는 에피소드 하나는 그 감자라는 그 강아지에 대한 애착이 생기시면서 그 김유석 배우가 영화 이후에 진짜 감자를 당신의 집안에 입양하셨어요.
그 반려견으로. 그 멍멍이를요?
아니요, 그건 아니고 같은 종의 그 강아지를 입양해서 이름을 감자라고 지었죠.
아, 영화 속에서의 감자를 현실에서 이어가신 거네요?
그렇죠.
아, 예, 알겠습니다. 너무 재밌네요. 제가 이거 간단하게 불어로 통역할게요.
네.
Ma première question était un petit peu personnelle, c'était adressée à Madame Hong, parce que quand elle a raconté son histoire de localisation de stranger, de chien, du chien, le chien vers Kamja, pomme de terre, je pensais tout de suite que c'est à cause de la différence culturelle entre la France et la Corée, parce que chez nous en Corée, c'est très banal, c'est plutôt une tendance de donner le nombre de nourriture pour les animaux domestiques. Donc quand j'ai entendu Kamja, je me suis dit que c'est à cause de ça, parce que moi aussi, j'ai mon chat, il s'appelle Ravioli. Donc, Madame Hong, elle a répondu que c'est vrai que c'est à cause de ça et aussi c'est pour qu'on fasse une localisation bien adaptée en Corée. Donc, il y a un ami du rôle principal qui l'a en baignoire en France, mais ça a été changé vers le citron. Citron en Jeju, l'île de Jeju, et aussi il y a une chose très intéressante pour le rôle principal en coréen, Kim Yoon-seok. Pendant le tournage, il était attaché tellement à Kamja, le chien, donc après le tournage, il a décidé d'adopter le même chien, donc visuellement presque pareil, et aussi donner le nom Kamja pour lui. Donc Pomme de terre a été continuée, pas seulement dans le film, mais aussi dans la réalité, et c'était très intéressant comme une histoire. Donc il y a d'autres questions pour tout le monde? Hop, hop. 질문 있으십니까?
Ah oui.
Oui.
Je propose que on clôture.
Si ah oui.
Il est pile poil 11h45.
D'accord.
So we're gonna say thank you so much to every participant, and it was like super interesting.